Hello everyone, welcome to the lecture on community blogging. This lecture is a part of your paper on community media and society. In this module, you will learn the relevance of blogging for the interests of various communities. Since certain communities are subjected to a series of deprivations and their human rights are denied, their lives are at stake. Blogs, alternative means of communication, are constantly engaged in warding off social taboos through a participatory nature of communication. The internet has become a very essential part of our daily life. With the proliferation of the internet, the era of blogging has commenced and has significantly marked a virtual space among the public. Up to the late 1990s, the terminology of blog was not coined. Before blogging was popular, digital communities emerged in digital forms. Later, the early 2000s witnessed the significant growth of blogs. Hence, its popularity has grown by leaps and bounds and carved out niche in the domain of alternative means of communication. Now, let us look at blogging and media of communication. Blogging as a digital medium of communication provides space for digital contents for the purpose of dissemination of facts and views. Some blogs are intended for small groups, while some deliberately aimed at audience at large scale. Though certain contents blogging can reach out the masses without filtering of any content, since gatekeeping is almost nil. Since the dissemination process is free flow, it is now getting more and more popular among the audience. Moreover, it is often confused with mass media, as there is a blurring line between a blog and mass communication channels. Some argue that blogging is a part of journalism, which paves the way for participatory journalism. Citizen journalism through various bloggings could be termed as participatory communication, which is often required in the process of socio-economic development. Hence, it can be termed as an agent of social change and development. Now, let us look at blogging and digital activism. A digital activism campaign is a digitally enabled public effort in which the people behind the movement use digital media platforms. The movement could be against a powerful person or organization. When the function of blogging for digital activism is concerned, it broadly falls into three categories: awareness or advocacy, organization or mobilization, and third, action or reaction. Sometimes it is also felt that it is the medium which is the message for the masses. Since blogging is a part of digital platforms, it facilitates participatory communication, which further helps in emancipation of a given community. With the growing use of the internet and the emergence of online communities, digital activism is taking off in India. But its pace is slower than in developed countries. Illiteracy of citizens and inaccessibility of computers and the internet are the potential constraints before a community to use a blog at its best. Moreover, the strategies used and the measurement of success or failure of such activism remain complex here. Now, we will look at blogging for the need of community. Blogging can have emancipatory approaches in their functions. It can bring a community or communities in the process of critical involvement, which further leads to socio-economic development. It gives voice to the voiceless by breaking the cultural silence. Blogs run by this school of thought and orientation can be instrumental to the upliftment of any marginalized community. Now, we will look at blogging and Dalit community. In India, there are certain blogs which are active on the lines of caste system and marginalization. Certain bloggings are quite essential to explore and retain the identity of certain communities. Dalits as subalterns are subjected to deprivations and dejections in the Indian society. Ranajit Guha asserts that subaltern is the demographic difference between the total Indian population and all those whom we have described as the elite. He condemns that the contribution of subaltern groups to the Indian nationalism as it remains overlooked by the elite historiographers. Perhaps this could be one of the reasons for which Dalits have been paying a heavy price for their marginalization and lower participation at the ladder of decision making and execution. Now let us look at certain examples. Madiga community and Madiga Dandora are about the community of Madiga. It is the community residing in the states of Andhra Pradesh, Telangana, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu. Perhaps this virtual community came online because they wanted to give a push to the Madiga community to the limelight amongst Dalit communities. It is also reportedly said that this community has the least access to reservation and other benefits from various governmental bodies. This particular blog tries to establish an identity of Madiga community in the entire community of Dalits. Other blogs like Dalit Information and Education Trust are active to disseminate information on socio-economic development and social justice to the entire Dalit communities. While attempting to bring social justice to this subsection of scheduled caste, the blogs critically communicate various policies of government bodies. Similarly, leftward blog comprising the write-ups from politicians to activists is digital media which makes discourses on human rights, marginalization, activism and the like. This is not mere a media of disseminating information, rather it critically reviews the information. This community media aims at orienting the readers towards criticality of state policy and implementation and to witness social changes by overcoming state repressions and social taboos. In addition, these blogs have been instrumental to create social movements to fight against social odds gripping the society on a large scale. In this context, Graham Kirkpatrick, in his book Technology and Social Power, underlines that technology can be socially constructed. Blogging, termed as social construction, can foster the sense of liberation through technological innovations. Pertaining to the effectiveness of blogging, Mary Joyce has rightly enunciated that the digital technology can lead to digital activism and usher in an era of equality and social justice. Now, let us look at blogging and disability community. There have been certain instances when a blog fosters human right tempo among the virtual communities. Some blogs are there in which digital communication occurs for the communities who are at the bottom level of awareness and securing their human rights. Going beyond the common issues of the disabled, these virtual groups attempt to communicate and resolve the problem in the area of gender, geography, and types of disability in India. The 2011 census claims that the disabled are 2.21% of India's total population. However, they have been subjected to a series of deprivations and human rights are grossly violated. The blog Enable India to Empower People with Disability is a popular digital media among the disabled and disability rights activists, especially in India. Since its inception in the year 2007, it has been critically disseminating human rights and various public policies implemented from governmental bodies in India. A disabled with the tag of a woman doubly suffers, and it has been rightly termed as double discrimination. In her article, Can the Subaltern Speak?, Gayatri Chakravarti Spivak claims that intellectuals or dominant class constitute the subaltern as anonymous and mute. By applying the philosophy of deconstruction, she further looks into the position of subalterns who lack access to citizenship. Spivak has feminized and globalized the philosophy of deconstruction to understand the history, geography, and class in thinking women. Spivak's understanding of women is quite apt to probe the status of women with disabilities. This alternative means of communication speaks louder to break the jinx, to attain the equality between a disabled man and disabled women. Sexuality is a less talked stuff in the public. Moreover, the public discourse on sexuality of women with disabilities is almost scant and hence requires urgent attention. A blog called JJ's List, which covers varied dimensions including women, disability and sexuality. This blog endorses the sexuality as a human right of the disabled women worldwide. Communication to the community is quite rampant. Now, how not to accept the pity or medical model of disability? In this context, Anita Silvers, in her article, Repricing Women's Disability, Feminist Identity Strategy and Disability Rights has stressed on feminist identity strategy and disability rights. In addition, Anastasia Kawada, in her article, Activism Transformed Digital, the Social Media Perspective, hints at the role of the networked structure of social movements which give birth to community participation. Blogging, a means of digital activism, paves the way for social transformation with a loose, flexible, and decentralized structure. Hence, it is the blogging of these community types which exert in building solidarity and a sense of collective identity of women with disabilities pertaining to the rights of sexuality. Now, let us look at blogging and LGBT community in India. Blogs in India are taking off to cover the issues of communities like lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender. Talking of LGBT here is not that much of openness like in the developed countries on the globe. The blog Queer India is all about sexuality, gender, pop culture, and queer activism. Unlike the mainstream media, the blog is making sincere efforts to focus on the issues of the LGBT communities. Needless to say, their identity has gone for toss despite their repeated appeal to the public and government. The blogging on this community manifests how the community is being stigmatized and detached from the mainstream society. Since the LGBT community is stigmatized, it is essential to theorize this state through various forms of communication emanating from blogging. Erwin Goffman's theory of social stigma states that it is the stigma which causes individual to be mentally classified by others in a stereotyped manner rather in an accepted style. It creates a gap between virtual social identity and actual social identity. In the context of this community, the communication is being occurred how they are pushed to the state of virtual social identity, which is manufactured, humiliated, and undervalued. The communication from this digital platform has proved a potential alternative to the mainstream and condemned ideological state apparatus, what Louis Althusser speaks in his theory of ideology. This community media is vehemently against the state machinery and its illegal and illogical control. In the light of sexuality, the argument of Sigmund Freud in positioning the same is vivid. Sexual repression is rampant, unhealthy, and the indirect cause of much crime, illness, and woe. The communication fostering the idea of activism is signaling the violation of this community's human rights, that is, their right to sex and reproduction. Queer India is ideating and endorsing their sexual orientation or gender identity in the Indian society. The blogging of this kind is sincerely trying to provide a social and cultural identity to the LGBT communities. Sometimes this alternative digital communication covers the protests from the community, showcasing their solidarity and a sense of collective identity. Since the politics of recognition towards their community is weak and diluted from the front of mainstream, communication from blogs has become inevitable to get rid of such low-level tendencies. In his value-added theory, or social strain theory, Niels Melzer underlines that there are certain necessary conditions required for social movement to emerge. The sequence of stages are structural conduciveness, structural strain, generalized belief, precipitating factors, mobilization for action, and operation of social control. However, in India, the social movement for the LGBT community is at the stage of structural conduciveness, where certain amount of agitation is going on. The blogging on this community is slowly taking the stage from structural conduciveness to structural strain, a stage where people at the helm of power are unable to control the issues of the community. Therefore, bloggings on the line of social movements are undergoing a paradigm shift in terms of approach and evaluation. Let us now look at blogging and rural community. Blogging is spreading its presence in the development sectors. Since the mainstream media do not pay minimum heed to the issues of rural regions in India, certain blogs like Rural Development in India has come forward and has proved as an agent of alternative media for rural development. Through this blog, communication is not all about rural services alone. Rather, it covers on various aspects like business opportunities, information and communication technologies, rural technologies, core thoughts, social entrepreneurship, rural market, low-cost devices, rural distribution, grassroots innovators, funding, government schemes, rural investments, primary education, rural marketing, academic perspectives, microfinance, rural health, e-learning, rural schooling, and women issues in rural India. Probably, it attempts to break the notion of digital divide by covering on numerous dimensions of rural development. By covering various aspects of rural India, the blog of this kind attempts to instill the idea of inclusive development through various types of development communication. Moreover, information dissemination pieces on rural health, rural market, and rural schooling are reorienting community awareness and attention. The write-ups like Innovations Waiting in Selling Insurance Policies for Rural India under Rural Health, Why Chassis Are Popular in Rural India under Rural Marketing, and School Dropout Rates is Very High in Rural India, Why under Rural Schooling are worthy enough to be cited and discussed. It is also found that this blog is quite diversified and tries to democratize the information meant for audience of varied types. Now let us come to the conclusion. Suffice to say that community blogs can be instrumental in initiating and implementing digital activism for the well-being of a community. In the initial years, these were primarily disseminating information without critical approach. However, with the advent of social media, their importance has considerably gone up. There are instances where blogs have become substandard in terms of vision, content, and mode of delivery. Their agenda are being marred in the wake of personal and vested interests. the agenda of a community blogging is miserably getting lost. The act of gatekeeping, which ensures holistic modus operandi of information dissemination, is at stake, distorting the debates and discourses on an issue pertaining to the community. In his article, Destructive Activism, the Double-Edged Sword of Digital Tactics, Stephen Murdoch elucidates that what traditional media ignore, digital communication tools like blogs can compensate. However, minor blogs not matured in discourses and delivery publish the incorrect information. They are not agreed to check with their facts for dissemination, and they keep on spreading disinformation. In June 2009, false rumors of accidents at several nuclear power plants in Russia operated by Energoatom can be apt in this context. Unfortunately, a community blogging could also be counterproductive. To keep the blogging as a means of communication productive and ethical, community attached to the digital platform should be alert on a constant basis. Hence, the agenda behind a community blogging should be pious and judicious gatekeeping from the community itself should prevail in order to usher in an era of social development, social identity, social justice, and equality through free flow of information. Providing the space of equality among the community in terms of production, distribution, and consumption of content, a blog can meet the very purpose of a community in identifying, retaining, building, and strengthening the same in the given period of time. For more details, please read the module carefully and attempt the questions given at the end of each module. Thank you.